and welcome. Thank you for coming here for our spring fall concert. Just a couple of things. If you noticed right at the top of that inside page, you saw this lovely announcement. Please make sure your phones are turned to silent. If you would, any other kind of noise-making device. We've been fortunate enough that if something should happen that you have a small one, although I don't see any small ones out here tonight, but that we've actually got it into the outside the auditorium that you can actually continue to watch it out there. So just thank you again for taking care of that for us. We've got a lot of music that we want to share with you, but we'd like to do it without any extra help right now, at least. So. And thank you, really, thank you for coming. We appreciate you and your support of what we're doing here at Barton. And these students have been doing some remarkable work, and I'm really, really happy with what's been going on. We are gonna flip the program here in just a minute. I put it in the wrong order, and I'll take that one. So instead of having the guys come out and go first, so it should be ladies first anyway, that's why I had it in my head. So the ladies of Dolce, they've got just a little number from Wicked that they want to share, and they're going to share a little bit of popular from that musical, and they've got a little extra help so that they can get into this just a little bit. Dolce this semester has been a little smaller group. We had 6 and 7, and with the flip in semesters, it didn't work out with schedule, so we're kind of down to a duet. So we've got Aaron Cox and Taryn Roble as part of Dolce. And we've got Emma King sitting in as trying to figure out how to be popular. So ladies.
Bye. Do or die,
the world loves love.
to sing, sing, sing. Guys got to sing, guys got to sing, sing, sing. Gonna make the rafters ring, now it's a fact, there ain't no doubt. Singing's what it's all about, just sing, sing, sing. Sing, sing, sing. Sing, sing, sing. Guys got to sing.
Circumstance that you're in, and this is one of the things that we kind of started pulling a little bit more the further we got into this year and this semester, is the fact that we have this opportunity to kind of make sure that we're there for each other. I call it community. We have a community inside the choir, and it's a wonderful thing to have, and I think they're feeling that idea of community and the fact that we're always there for each other. And that we want to make sure that we're there for each other, no matter what they may be experiencing. And so there's a little bit of that that I'm just sharing right here, and then I'll share a little bit more a little bit later as we get back into what we're doing with concert choir. But we're going to go ahead and start with Amazing here, and we'll go one from one straight into each number, and we'll do the whole set with Hilltop Singers.
I'm living right here and now, and I don't want to miss out. Is this what life's all about? The world is Have you ever felt like nobody was there? Have you ever felt forgotten in the middle of nowhere? Have you ever felt like you could disappear? Like you could fall and no one would hear?
Broken on the ground, you will be found. So let the sun come streaming in, 'cause you'll reach up and your eyes again. If you won't give up the ground, you will be found.
belong to me. You'll be back, time will tell. You'll remember that I served you well. Oceans rise, empires fall. We have seen each other through it all. And when push comes to shove, I will send a fully armed battalion to remind you of my love.
And she helped out, and she did the choreography for the entire Hamilton piece. So thank you, and a round of applause to all three of those choir. So as you looked at the beginning of this program, and I tried to put some notes in here as well for you to kind of take a look at as you went through, the idea behind this program was our reason to sing. Well, we've had a bunch of reasons to try to figure out how do we get together in the last 2 years. You know, how do we do that? How do we make it happen? With COVID, with everything else, with being separated, and what reasons do we have to sing? And I kind of asked that question. So what is it about singing? Why are you here? Why are you a part of what's happening at Barton? And they know I'm going to do this. I told them I was going to do this because I asked them that question. And they provided me with just some different answers. So I'm going to share with you some of the things that they said, okay? And one of the first ones here is, singing is a way of release from everyday pressure that we feel. And I know for a lot of them at this age, there seems to be a lot of that in place. And so a place to release some of that is something that is amazing and wonderful that we get to do through singing. It's a way to celebrate, to mourn, tell someone how you feel, and even brighten your mood. And hopefully I help do that in the middle of everything else. Another one, I seem to enjoy the moment, the breath, and the sound. Just kind of sharing, singing's always been a big part of my life, and it's something that I've always enjoyed, and I can't imagine not doing it. Another one, it allows me to escape from my quote-unquote normal classes and daily responsibilities. Choir is another way to keep music and self-expression in my life. And that's one of the things I try to talk about with them, the self-expression portion of that. Even though we're singing the same text, there's always a different part of who they are and where they come from, that they approach the text in their own specific way. And so how they connect to each individual piece may be different than the person next to them, but it still affects them in a positive way. Going from that, I love to sing, and being able to use this wonderful gift that God gave me brings me a lot of joy. So the opportunity to kind of share that and to lift that voice in a different way, that's one of the things that kind of comes from that as well. And kind of this last one in this particular set that I'm going to go with, well, a couple more. This one says, I've been in a wide variety of sports, clubs, and activities, but music is something that I've never strayed away from. It gives me joy. That I can't find anywhere else. Whatever happens in my life, I will always have music. And that I will always sing. These next two are going to go back to you will be fed. Even when I'm broken and feel like I'm alone, there's always someone who cares about me. I'm not alone, no matter what. And this last one, she lost her grandma, and wanted to be to God. I like to think that when I sing, I continue to carry on with what she taught me, enjoy music. All right. Think a little bit about that, and it touches me, obviously. David.
Thank you.
we're fortunate to have these two lovely ladies to come in and play and accompany as part of this. So you'll notice in the program both of their names. And because in the middle of everything else, I'm probably going to butcher it. So. But I appreciate both of them being here. It adds so much to this piece. This particular text, as you look in, at what I wrote in the program notes, is just something that's been kind of taken as a Shaker or Quaker tune, but it really wasn't. Also, one of the things that was the text, the way we are seeing it, has actually kind of been altered and added to. So the second and third verse that really are part of the hymn have kind of been pulled out, and then when tyrants tremble is part of the text that we actually will be using on this. And Taylor Davis set this a number of years ago, and ever since I heard it initially, one of the things I really love just about the text and how it relates to kind of our inner emotions and how it connects for some of us very strongly, and how it's used for funerals and the thought of an after that life beyond the life that we have here. And that's why it's been used as a hymn so much in that tradition, especially for funerals. But just the way that between the violin and the oboe, the ethereal kind of feeling that it adds to all of this in this arrangement that I just truly find amazing. So thank you, ladies. I appreciate both you being here for that. And I'm going to get to Carol in a minute here. But we're going to sing first, How Can I Keep From Seeing?
Thank you. there's something that we need to kind of look over, because there's someone who, if it weren't for her, this wouldn't happen. And she's had to put up with a whole lot, just ask her. Because she's had to put up with me. And I really want to say thank you. That's okay, they have to. But she does it. And, but Carol has done so much through this year for me, especially kind of as walking in and doing everything. When I need to do a sectional, it's like, can you take this? And she says, yeah, no problem. And she helps out. And when I got to go to a school or something like that, she says, okay, I'll try to run rehearsal and do things like that. And I need to say thank you to you for that, number one. But also number two, that this is kind of a last part. I can't believe you're okay. Because bouquets don't last. Mm. So I thought you could do with this plan as you'd like, if you want to leave it in the pot or where you get where you're going, that you can put it there. So, thank you. Rejoice and sing out his praises. This is a Mark Hayes arrangement. I told them that this is one of the songs that when I got into college, Mark was actually working on music for the conductor that I was working under in college. So that's to tell you a little bit about that. But I actually got to do the recording of this particular piece in a studio, so as our choir did this in the studio, and that recording that we did went to from the publisher out to all the people who wanted to hear this piece and wanted to listen to it before they purchased it. So it's been a lot of fun for me to kind of come back around and share this particular piece. It's a lovely kind of gospel tune. Mark Hayes, if you don't know, is over in Kansas City. He's been there, gosh, for a long, long time. But he's one of those arrangers that does a lot of wonderful things, and he's got some wonderful, just new music of his own as well. But this arrangement of Rejoice and Sing Out His Praises, I hope you enjoy it. We'll finish out tonight.
Rejoice and sing of his praises. Sing
out. I will sing to him all of my days.
Sing
Take a look at those, and may you have a wonderful rest of your evening. Thank you for coming again.